Everyone is talking about inheritance tax after this.
Let me tell you, in America, there is an inheritance tax. That's an interesting law. It says you, in your generation, made wealth. You are leaving now. You must leave your wealth for public.
अब कांग्रेस का कहना है कि वो इनहेरिटेंस टैक्स लगाएगी, माता पिता से मिलने वाली विरासत पर भी टैक्स लगाएगी। आप जो अपनी मेहनत से संपत्ति जुटाते हैं वो आपके बच्चों को नहीं मिलेगी, बल्कि कांग्रेस सरकार का पंजा उसे भी आपसे छीन लेगा।
मैं साफ कर देना चाहता हूँ कि इस न्याय पत्र में विरासत कर का कोई जिक्र नहीं है। विरासत कर हमारा एजेंडा नहीं है।
And well, inheritance tax has triggered a war of words between the Congress party and BJP after the former advisor of Rajiv Gandhi and associate of Rahul Gandhi, Sam Pitroda, described it as an interesting law. Prime Minister Narendra Modi has alleged the Congress party would snatch property left behind by people for their children. So what is inheritance tax all about? Did India ever have it? And is it good or bad? Let's discuss today. Starting from what is this law? It comes from the West. The United States levies two types of taxes, estate tax and inheritance tax. Six states in America impose inheritance tax: Iowa, Kentucky, Maryland, Nebraska, New Jersey and Pennsylvania. However, Iowa will abolish it by 2025. Now, this tax is applicable when a person who dies passes on his assets and is from any of these six states to an inheritor. Now, here the inheritor pays the inheritance tax, not the estate of the deceased. तो basically person जिसको inheritance मिल रही है वो inheritance tax pay करता है. Now Pitroda ने इसको बहुत अच्छे से explain किया है और कहा है कि $100 million की अगर आपकी wealth है और आप गुजर जाते हो तो 45% inheritor के पास जाएगा और 55% government के पास.
So if let's say one has $100 million worth of wealth and when he dies, he can only transfer probably 45% to his children. 55% is grabbed by government. Now that's an interesting law.
Now this is what he has said, but inheritance tax rates in the US range from less than 1% to 18% of the property's value and cash that the person inherits, but they can change every year, so it is not fixed. Now these taxes are usually levied on those who don't have a family relationship with the deceased. Spouses and charitable organizations are exempt from the tax, and even children and grandchildren may qualify for an exemption or a partial exemption. Like in Pennsylvania, the tax rate is 45% on transfers to direct descendants, 12% on transfer to siblings, and 15% on transfer to others. Now, not only in the US, but it is applicable in the UK, South Korea, and Japan as well. In the UK, 40% of inheritance tax is levied on assets worth over £325,000 or 3.37 crore rupees. In Japan, it is the highest with 55% inheritance tax. In South Korea, there is 50% inheritance tax. And the classic example in South Korea was Samsung Electronics chairman when he said that he would pay 12 trillion won in inheritance tax for the estate of the late patriarch. Now talking about this, आपको ये भी पता होना चाहिए कि इंडिया में भी ये impose किया जाता था और ये abolish किया था राजीव गांधी की government ने ही 1985 में. An estate duty was a form of tax that was calculated at the time of the person's death. It was introduced through Estate Duty Act of 1953. And it was payable only if total value of inherited portion of property exceeded the exclusion limit. In India, it was set as high as 85% on properties. So properties worth at least 1.5 lakh rupees were taxed at a rate of 7.5%. Iska objective was to narrow income disparity, par ye 1985 mein abolish kiya gaya tha. During VP Singh, jab wo finance minister the, tab unhone kaha tha ki estate duty ka yield was about 20 crore rupees aur iska administration cost wo bahut high hai. तो उन्होंने प्रपोज किया था कि अबॉलिश कर दिया जाए. फॉर एग्जाम्पल, एज पर द 1980-81 रेगुलर बजट, ग्रॉस टैक्स रेवेन्यू फॉर 1979-80 वॉज 11,447 करोड़ रुपीज, आउट ऑफ विच एस्टेट ड्यूटी ओनली कॉन्ट्रीब्यूटेड 13 करोड़ रुपीज. which is merely 0.1% of the total tax revenue. अब प्राइम मिनिस्टर नरेंद्र मोदी ने भी इनको क्रिटिसाइज किया है ये कहते हुए कि राजीव गांधी के टाइम पे ही इसको अबॉलिश किया गया था. लिसन इन.
जब देश की एक प्रधानमंत्री बहन इंदिरा जी नहीं रही तो उनकी जो मिलकत थी, उनकी जो प्रॉपर्टी थी, वो उनकी संतानों को मिलनी थी. लेकिन पहले ऐसा कानून था कि वो उनको मिलने से पहले एक हिस्सा सरकार ले लेती थी. कांग्रेस ने पहले ऐसा कानून बनाया था. तब चर्चा थी और व्यापक रूप से चर्चा थी कि जब इंदिरा जी नहीं रही और उनके बेटे राजीव गांधी जी को ये प्रॉपर्टी मिलने की थी, लिख करके गई थी, तो अब सरकार को पैसा चला ना जाए, प्रॉपर्टी को बचाना था, तो इन्होंने क्या कर दिया, उस प्रॉपर्टी को बचाने के लिए अपनी माता इंदिरा गांधी से मिले हुए पैसों को बचाने के लिए उस समय के प्रधानमंत्री श्रीमान राजीव गांधी ने अपनी संपत्ति बचाने के लिए पहले जो इनहेरिटेंस कानून था उसको समाप्त किया और खुद के पैसे बचा लिए.
नाउ इज इट गुड और बैड द इनहेरिटेंस टैक्स? वेल, एज पर अ स्टडी बाय ऑर्गेनाइजेशन फॉर इकोनॉमिक कोऑपरेशन एंड डेवलपमेंट व्हाट वाज मेड टू इराडिकेट इनकम इनइक्वालिटी, द इनहेरिटेंस टैक्स हैज मेड इनइक्वालिटी इवन वर्स एंड ओनली अ माइनर सोर्स ऑफ रेवेन्यू कम्स फ्रॉम inheritance tax in most countries. While some back it, in an old interview which is going viral now, Nikhil Kamath had said that inheritance tax will bring more people under the tax net. So there are mixed opinions about inheritance tax. What is your view? Tell us in the comments and like, share and subscribe to ET Now for more such news and views.
For more of such videos, do like, share and subscribe to ET Now Swadesh.